This tutorial continues our overview of Grid View, and we will show you some other powerful features and useful tips. Our document is an XML file that is currently displayed in text view. This file also has a schema definition. XMLSpy uses this schema to check the validity of our document. Now let's switch to Grid View. Besides using standard Grid View, we can also enable table mode. In table mode, repeating nodes are displayed as the rows of a table. Let's set the optimal width of the columns to make our records look more user-friendly. Now let's add a new record. We would like to insert a new record after the last one. Therefore, we will select the last record and then click this toolbar command. An empty row has appeared. Now let's switch to text view to see the changes. At the moment, our new record is completely empty, and only two elements are displayed. This is because only these two elements are mandatory in the schema, and the optional nodes are not added to a new record automatically. Note that mandatory nodes are shown with solid borders, and optional nodes have dashed borders. Now let's go back to the XML file and switch to Grid View. When we return to Grid View, the records are displayed in standard Grid View again. And if you want XMLSpy to show your data in table mode automatically, you will need to open the Grid View settings and then enable the Detect Tables option. Besides, we also want all records to be displayed with the optimal width by default. Now let's test the settings. Now let's work on our new book record. The record is called the Black Tower. Let's type it in the title column. Of course, you can always enter your data manually, but this is quite tedious. XMLSpy enables you to copy data from external text editors and web pages and paste the data into your document. We've got an Excel spreadsheet that contains information about ordered books. Let's copy some data and paste it using the standard Windows commands. Besides, we can also select a couple of cells in Excel and drag them into the document. While we are dragging the cells, the pop-up informs us about the number of selected columns and rows. Before selecting a genre, let's take a quick look at the schema. The genre element has an enumeration facet that allows defining a list of possible values. To select one of the values from the schema, we'll simply double-click the cell and then select Crime and Mystery. As for the country and period, we will copy the existing values. The author comes from the UK, so we need to select this cell and then press and hold the Ctrl key while dragging the value down. And we will do the same for the period. All that is left to do is copy and paste the date of entry and the price. After pasting the data, we can see that XMLSpy is unhappy about one of the values. According to the schema, the date of entry is of type date. And the highlighted value doesn't comply with this type. Luckily, we can use the smart fix to quickly get the right value. And the file is now valid. Let's take a look at the new record in text view. Compared to standard grid view, table view offers unique editing benefits. For example, you can sort your data on the basis of a particular column. Let's say we want to sort our data based on the title element. We'll select this column and then click the sorting button in the toolbar. As a result, the data is sorted by title in ascending order. You can also sort your data in descending order. Importantly, sorting modifies your data. Let's switch to text view to see how the file has changed. Split view is another useful feature we would like to highlight. When you work with large documents, you may need to see and check various parts of your document simultaneously. You can split your document into two vertical or two horizontal windows. Since our file is pretty broad, it would make sense to split it horizontally. Let's press and hold the double arrow icon and drag the line down. One of the advantages is that you can scroll and navigate separately in each view of split view. By the way, as we scroll down, the table headers get pinned to the top. This makes it much easier to see the correspondence between the nodes and their values. Now let's assume we are working on some price value and want to check what the currency is. The currency attribute is located at root level, and we can't see it in this part of the document. Instead of scrolling all the way up and then back to the record we are working on, we can quickly check the currency in the other window of split view. This way we won't lose track of the data we are working on. As you see, the currency attribute shows US dollars. To remove split view, we simply need to double-click the dividing line in the middle. You can test all these features yourself. Simply download the fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altava website.